A former Native American chief in court accused of stealing from her people.
An alleged betrayal. Good evening, I'm Stephanie Gorin.
And I'm George Mallet. Police say money's missing from a Native American tribe. Now prosecutors accuse the tribe's former chief of embezzling the loot.
New at 6, News Channel 5's Jax Thurston tried getting answers from the longtime leader.
So April, how you feeling today?
April St. Francis Merrill ignored us completely.
What do you make of these new charges, April?
As she walked into the criminal court in St. Albans, Vermont Monday.
I've retained counsel.
Inside, she pled not guilty to allegations she stole from the very people who looked up to her. The Native American tribe members she served as chief. St. Francis Merrill is a familiar face in northwestern Vermont, having pushed for decades, along with her late father, for formal recognition of her band of Abenaki, based in Swanton.
Today is a proud day for our people.
The Missisquoi won state recognition last month, but by then, St. Francis Merrill had stepped down as chief, citing personal reasons.
The money was there.
And Franklin County Prosecutor Jim Hughes now says those reasons may include an investigation of embezzlement. Police accuse the former chief of siphoning more than $34,000 from tribal accounts through ATM withdrawals, grocery shopping, flower purchases, even installing a deck on her own home with money detectives say was meant to benefit needy children at an annual Christmas party.
There were many other things purchased on that account that never came to the party and are alleged to have gone into her possession.
A little over a year ago, the former chief faced similar charges for allegedly pocketing money from an elderly man whose finances she was supposed to be minding. The prosecutor ended up dropping those charges, saying because that man is dead, it would be very difficult to prove guilt in that case.
St. Francis Merrill denied three new embezzlement counts. Conviction could mean jail time and a call for restitution. In St. Albans, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.